us this month from Ezekiel chapter number 16 from verse 4. On the day you were born, your cord was not cut, nor were you washed with water to make you clean, nor were you rubbed with salt or wrapped in clothes. So that's a word that has been leading us, trying to remind us when we were born, trying to remind us where we started with God. And I was asking myself, why is this analogy or allegory talking about water? And I was getting to understand that water symbolizes the Holy Spirit. And I don't want to dwell so much, but the Spirit of God was taking me to the Word of God that talks about the Holy Spirit. And I was reading Galatians 5 and verses 16, where the Bible says that, These I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary then one to another, to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. So the Bible is reminding us, when we started with the Lord, we were not washed with water, and water symbolizes the Holy Spirit. And this morning I want to stress the need of walking in the Spirit. And that is the only way we are not going to fulfill the desires of the flesh. Or else you know what's over Madina my gemuno Marco Gotuarana and Meriria Moruma Muiri. Now, Gadoma Galatians, we could look at the neighborhood of Meriria Mount Marico. Kogua and Neta Kuga get a conny than Yakioke Horoa with Abiona Maeri. At the Nohoroa or Homo the Ruangaire. Nita kuerua hae de Paul ora yetu atiririria mwafatirio kana riria mwetekirie ni mwayuririo na roho mutheru wanga tondu mundu no angikorwa ta yuritio na roho mutheru ri no athie na mbere uhoro wa gutwarana na meririria moru ma mwiri kuguo ruci ni rwa muthenya wa mothe. I want to start by emphasizing that we need to desire to be filled with the Holy Spirit every day, and that is the only solution. That is the only thing that will help us not to go according to the flesh. May the name of the Lord be glorified. I feel it in my spirit that we need the Holy Spirit. I call one to kwenda kure gwarurira. I call one to kwenda. Narurira uri arwikaga ri. It is separate, it connects the mother and the child. And that's why matikidina bere gutura, the mother and the baby cannot live together. They have to be separated so that the baby can live it independently. Kugo mudo wanga inake utarege to rurirari. Mudo utanabetio na mai mudo utayureto ya homo the ruanga ire. No atore o anyitida netio na maudumari amenaga na maudumari aragi against. Kugo, this morning I have a strong desire, and I want to urge you to do the same, to desire even the more to be filled day in, day out with the Spirit of God. And once you do that, you're going to be free. You're going to be separated. As I just told you, that the umbilical cord connects the mother and the baby. The last time I dwelt so much on how the umbilical cord feeds. And I was trying to tell you that the cord needs to be cut so that it will not continue to feed us with the things of the past. Maudu maria matene toa, retoa ikagatere rehende wengi. Ate gainye kufatara oke arege rurira. Na negana rurira roro tia to feed na maudu kuma na korea tumete. Na guro shine wamu danya wamu odi, kireata kuari ya uhoro wa aleri. Ate rurira, rurare kuare kuare, niru tigida nagia mwana na mami wao. Reto wale angai ni rogo shuo. Kugwa niko kugia no horo wa kutongori yoniro homo dhali wangai. tuthambio na maaĩ ũguo nĩguo mwathani ekaga rĩrĩa aingĩra mĩtũrĩre itũ okaga agatũiyũria na roho mũtheru tondũ maaĩ symbolizes the Holy Spirit. I feel like we can dwell here the entire month just talking about gũthambio na maaĩ na rĩu ningĩ ũhoro wa aya andũ araria ũhoro wa cumbĩ. You are not wrapped with the salt. And I was thinking, what is the purpose of salt in this life? And I was getting to understand that in the ancient days, salt was used for preservation. Chumbe wawa uthagirwo kugireria kindu gitigathuke. Ritwa ria Ngai rirogocwo. Kuguo oro wa guthaku kuhurwo na chumbe ri ni ku preserve kugirerio tutigathuke. Turaikara in a rotten world. We have seen things that they have never been experienced by other people in the generations. Urona maundu me magigi no kona maundu moru. No hindi ya mundu atuika ni mundu uhuretwo na cumbi-ri, agathuguo cumbi wega ri, ona agiikara thi ina maundu moru ri, we no aikare e preserved. So I pray, I want to start with, that is not my message this morning, but I was feeling the Holy Spirit compelling me to talk about the desire to be filled with the Holy Spirit, and number two, to be wrapped with salt. Gũtuĩkate nĩtwahurwo na cumbĩ tondũ nĩthĩ nĩthũkĩte mũno kũrĩa tũikaraga. Maũndũ nĩ mathũkĩte mũno. No hĩndĩ ĩrĩa mũndũ atuĩka nĩ ahurwo na cumbĩ wega rĩ, atĩ mũndũ ũcio no atuĩke preserved. May the Lord preserve you. Ona kwĩna maũndũ maingĩ, ona kwĩna ũhoro wa andũ maũndũ moimĩrĩte maraguoyohia andũ rĩ, Ngai angĩkorwo kũpreserve. I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that the Lord will preserve you. Number one, the Lord will fill you with His Spirit. And the Lord will preserve you. Kũrĩa guothe ũrĩthiaga. Kũguo wee ndũrĩtuĩkaga wa kũinfluenswo nĩ thĩ. Wee nĩwe ũrĩinfluenzaga thĩ. Biblia yugaga atĩ inyuĩ nĩ inyuĩ cumbĩ wa thĩ. You are the salt of the world. Kũguo watuĩka mũndũ ũhurĩtwo wega na cumbĩ rĩ, agacoka akaiyũrio na roho mũtheru wega rĩ, rĩtwa rĩa Ngai rĩrogocwo. Wee ũkiumagara na kũrĩa nja wĩ mũndũ ũrathĩtwo wega na cumbĩ. Kũguo wathiĩ na kũrĩa nĩ ũgũcamia thĩ wega. Na rĩu ningĩ maandĩko mathiaga na mbere makoria atĩrĩrĩ, atĩ cumbĩ ũngĩthira mũcamo, if the salt loses its savor, what need is it for? Ũkerwo atĩ no gũteo ũteagwo ũkarangĩrĩrio nĩ andũ. Ngai atũhake cumbĩ, tũhurwo na cumbĩ nginya tũtuĩke cumbĩ, rĩtwa rĩa Ngai rĩrogocwo. Na nĩgetha tũgĩthiĩ na kũrĩa nja tũtuĩke cumbĩ, tũ preserve thĩ, tũ preserve kũrĩa tũikaraga, tũ preserve mĩciĩ itũ, tũ preserve maũndũ marĩa mothe twĩtanagio namo matigathũke, tondũ cumbĩ is a preservative. Anyways, so mau timo maandĩko marĩa nyuma ma mũthenya wa ũmũthĩ. No ngũdwell hau atĩ ũhoro wa separation. Ngai nĩ arenda gũtũ separate. Tondũ rũrĩra rwarengwo rũseparĩtaga mwana na mami wao. Ngai nĩ arenda atũseparĩti na maũndũ ma thĩ, na nĩgetha atũige handũ atũhũthĩre ta kĩndũ gĩake kĩa wĩra. Rĩtwa rĩa Ngai rĩrogocwo. Na nĩ ngwenda gũthoma ũhoro wa mũndũ ũmwe wĩ haha wonekete. Na ngwenda gũthoma thĩinĩ wa Matthew chapter number 8. The Bible says, when he came down from the mountain side. Ũyũ nĩ Mwathani Jesu. When he came down from the mountain side. Now I'm going to quote with my very first point this morning, that we serve a God who always step down. God is too high. Gai utheru wake ri ukire iguru muno. Gai uhoti wake ri uri iguru muno. Tondu gutiri undu ungigia ungirituha ati utuike ati Ngai witu ni uigire ni warituha muno. Ona maundu maria wonaga ta me maritu ugetigagira ri. Ta makati maritu kũrĩ Ngai witũ. Our God is so high. Ngai aikaraga igũrũ na ũhoti wake ũrĩ igũrũ mũno, ona ndũngĩkaringithanio na wao kana ũhoti wa Ngai witũ nĩ mũnene. No nĩ ngũkena, I'm so pleased with the opening statement of this chapter, that when he came down, I pray this morning that the Lord will come down. You may think you are so deep. No wĩcirie nĩ ũrikĩte kũndũ kũnene mũno. You are not too deep. No korwo ndũthiĩte kũrĩ kũriku mũno, ti kũriku. Ngai witũ nĩ oĩ kũharũrũka. Right to where you are. Kwĩ andũ monaga maũndũ mega. Some people when they are blessed, they become too high even to their relatives. They become too high even to their former friends. na makajia kuyethera arata ake akarandika o makaremwo ni kuharuruka no ni kuri ngai we matwine etagwo Jehovah. Jehovah li ati ni oi kuharuruka. When he came down from the mountainside, a large crowd followed him. Ni kuri na kirindi kia murumagirira na gutiri hindi gukaga kirindi kirarumirira Mwathani gutikaga. But something always happened. Ati ona hindi ya kirindi kirumirire Mwathani ni kuonekaga mundu umwe we no tiganu. Biblia koiga atiriri, a man with leprosy. And you know leprosy is a bad disease. You were not even supposed to live with the people. You were alienated. But he was in the crowd. And the Bible records that a man came and knelt before him and said, Lord, if you're willing, you can make me clean. Hai muduroka kera Mwathani akonia Mwathani ni maundu marikwa renda gutigithanurwo na. Enda gutigithanurwo na murimo wa mangu na nigetha so that he can continue to enjoy life. I pray this morning anything associated with you, anything connected to you, anything that is connecting you to pain, anything that is connecting you to fear, anything that is connecting you to self-defeating thoughts, anything that is connecting you to low self-esteem will be cut this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Adioka, this man came and knelt before God. Nereure, ududaraga nye atirere, kirendi ni kumurumirira kiramurumirira. But there is a man here who is following God with an open heart. And his purpose is to kneel before God. His purpose is to kneel before him so that he can plead with him to be separated with whatever, with what was causing him pain. Arenda gutigithanurwo na maundu maria mamutumaga akorwo ena ruo thini wa muturire wake. Maundu maria mamutwite kimene, maundu maria mamutwite mundu utangiendeka. He came to the Lord, and I want to thank the Lord this morning because you came. And I want to believe there is something that you would like to be separated with. God can separate you with shame. God can separate you with all those failures of life. Our God is able to do it. Na rewure mundu akiuga akiuga kugwa maruini. Now let me tell you, my friend, if you kneel before God, you can stand before kings. Anyone who kneels before God can stand before kings. Hey, ndotwana nyeri andu ange makaga gututwara hanene. But I came to tell you, make a habit of kneeling before God. Kneeling before God makes all the difference in your life. I pray that God will put a strong desire in my heart to always kneel before God. Not every day, 5 to 6. But God will put a desire that anytime I find a moment, I will kneel before him and I worship him. Kirendi ni kumurumirira kiramurumirira no ane aroneka mundu uramurumirira with a purpose to kneel before him. Na riria akire mundu uyu, when he knelt before God, he said, he reached, oh wait a minute, before him and he said, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. And this man is telling the Lord, if you are willing, allow me to be of service to you this morning and tell you that God is willing to come to your aid. The Lord is willing to come down. He is willing to come down and deal with your situation. Guy witu ni areda. Areda unagokiro ore areda. And that's the reason why he's calling you. He's telling you, come to me, all ye that labor, and I will give you rest. In fact, when you go to people with burdens, if you are calling people with your burdens every moment, it is not going to take long until they start now or even not answering your calls. People don't want to be burdened. But I came to tell you there is a God who is willing to take all your burdens this morning. Come to me. Come to me. There is an invitation. An open invitation. All ye that labor. There is no discrimination. The qualification is, are you laboring in your life? And what does it mean to labor? To labor means to make things happen with your own effort. Go to a car to inyue, multiplicate merigo merito, na neko muhurukia. There is a promise right there. Atemoke korenie inyue multiplicate merigo merito, mana neko muhurukia. Dawa ya ngai, to tuweke adu megwathe kira mwito wa ngai, to go where the Lord is. Tuwe kure otwara ga your burdens. Maybe you call people and you bother them with your burdens. Make a habit of taking your burdens to the Lord. Tuwara merigo ya kukure mwathani, nani yako kuhurukia. Tika kugeria muno, na kwe rutaneria, to make things happen. There is a God who is waiting this morning with open hands. And he's telling you, come to me, all ye that labor, and I will give you rest. Hallelujah. Letuwa reka ili rogo shuo. Nare ure, wake ruatelere, if you're willing, niguwa wiga, if you're willing. And I want to tell you that the Lord is willing. The Lord is willing. Na nikio dakwe la roi gathino wa Mathayo. Mathayo kuminemo mwari wa 28. Na gumi dho magaro shina was reading it in a different version this morning. And that verse 28 was starting with a good word, with a question in another version of the Bible. It was saying, are you tired? Are you worn out? Are you burned out on religion? Come to me, get away with me, and you will recover your life. Oh God, I was loving that version right there. Are you tired of relying on people? Are you tired? It's good to be tired. Are you worn out? It is possible to be worn out in this life, trying to make things happen. And somebody was explaining what it means to labor one day. A preacher was explaining what it means to labor. And he said it is like trying to push a tractor with no wheels on a muddy ground. Trying to move it is so hard. Nikaragita gatare magoro, nagatare niatia na uragaria ugasukuma ndoro. In life can feel like that at times. And the Bible is asking, are you tired? Are you worn out? Burn out on religion. Religion is all that they talk about is the do's and don'ts. That's the religion for you. Come to me, get away with me, and you will recover your life. I will show you how to make real rest, how to take real rest. At the moment, you're going to want to walk a quarter way, you're going to get to the end. After you got to go to a near, I will show you how to take real rest. Even when hell is breaking loose, I will show you how to rest and rely on me. Even when you are sick, I will teach you how to take rest in me, knowing that I'm Jehovah Rapha, God who heals. Even when you are experiencing lack in your life, hidire otare na pesha, hidiora ligwo nyumbe kuri huonaki. I'll teach you how to take rest. Even when you are facing opposition, come to me. I will teach you how to take rest in times of trouble. The Bible says that if you falter in times of trouble, how small is your faith? Kwea duma papa ikaga ni udu wode ni kupapa ika, utiri hii duma kora wome settled in this life. Mwadhani ya roiga ukai kule niye, ni kumuania ulea mundu wa huru kaga, jinyaliri ya maudu memoru muno, guwa gile ile li. Nino ugo utekua huru ka, ni kumeja niye na hoti, waku magarura, ona hindi ya mao ukiri ilu wawela ini na mushi waku wako ona madhina li. Uka guwa niye kwa huru ka, ulea mundu wa huru kaga, ati ugathiyaga ugikenaga uguo kiugaga ngai we munene ona gwikuru ni tondu wa riri ni kumenya ati ngai uria twinake ri ni ngai muthemba u ni ngai muthemba mwega mundu mwini wa rwe kwaraiga we ngai utahotaguo mindi na mindi ti kuma ira twina ngai muthemba utahotaguo ori kana ri na akiheana rekondi yake uhoro wa ciana cia Isiraeli uria marutire ukombo-ini na agika maundu mau mothe ngai ni arenda tuke na nigetha aturengerurira atutigithanure ndakwira rurira ni gutigithanwa rutigithanuraga mwana na nyina, and that is my point of the day. Ngai e maundu arenda guturenga na nigetha tutigithanie namo urucio wa guhabaika na gugikuwa mirigo mirito arenda turenga rurira atwe kihuruko atuoni uria mundu ahurukaga mundu no ahuruke nida na shambania na andu ona maundu mathukite athia wonaga tari kuigirirwo maraigirirwo wonaga tari tatugutarathi uguo thini wa miturire yao tondu andu acio no mahurukite kai ni arenda gututeithia uhoro ucio wa kuhuruka mundu uyu agiuka kuri Jesu akimwira if you are willing you can make me clean. And let me tell you what happened there. Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. That's my prayer. That's my desire. That when things are going haywire in my life, God will always stretch his hand and touch me. And let me tell you, when the Lord touches your life, when the Lord touches your finances, when the Lord touches your body, when the Lord touch your children, when the Lord touch your husband, when the Lord touch everything that you associated with, your life changes in a moment. Praise the name of the Lord. After the touch, the Lord said, I'm willing, he said, be clean immediately. Immediately, praise the name of the Lord. Immediately, when the Lord touch your life, immediately things start to happen. Immediately things start to take shape. When the Lord touch anything that you associated with, the Bible says the Lord will perfect all that pertains to me. When the Lord touch my life, he will perfect everything, and I mean everything that concerns me. Am I concerned about my children? When the Lord touches them, he perfected them. Am I concerned about my job? When the Lord touch my job, immediately, praise the name of the Lord. Immediately, when the Lord touch anything that is bothering you this morning, I pray that the Lord will stretch his hand and touch that situation and turn it around immediately. It didn't take time. It is not recorded how many days the man suffered from leprosy. But the moment the Lord touched him, immediately, I like the immediately part. He was cured of his leprosy. Then the Lord said, see that you don't tell anyone, but go show yourself to the priest and offer the gift Moses commanded as a testimony to them. Praise the name of the Lord. Ati thutha wa mundu uyu gutuika ni ahonio akirwo riu ri ndukere mundu riu tutindatukira andu muno maundu ati thie we onanie to the priest. There is a place for a priest. There will always be a place for the priest. Because ni kuonekete andu mategutia uhoro ucio wa ati Ngai andu amurite as priest. But I came to tell you, after the miracle, it is always necessary to offer a sacrifice, to go before the priest. Nitondu andu anio meimaga nitondu witu. Andu anio mahoyaga nitondu witu. Praise the name of the Lord. Mwathani ni aretana this morning. And I want to conclude here and tell you, and ask you, are you tired? Are you worn out? Are you burned out of religion? Let us go to the Lord. Let us get away with him, and we will recover our lives. He will show us how to take real rest. We'll walk with him and work with him. We'll walk and work with him. And the Bible continues to say, watch how I do it. Watch how I do it. We are called to be imitators of Christ. Be imitators of Christ as dearly loved children. He's telling us, learn the unforced rhythms of grace. The Lord is inviting us this morning. All of us who are having burdens in our lives, and he's telling us we need to learn the unforced rhythms of grace. Unforced rhythms of grace. Oh God, it is available this morning. Grace and merited favor. I won't lay anything heavy or ill-fitting on you. Keep company with me, and you will learn to live freely and lightly. That's what I want. The dread of the video is more than how to take rest this morning. Then the Kyojo Kire, Tamo Dosio Arena Magoro, Shinrom, the Jawamu. They had all my burdens to him. Then the dread of Okuga, the Leona, and the Kirawe, and the Kure, Maud Madena Mark, who could have more than the Ali. Adumoya told him about that one and the Mayweta. Now sometimes they get disappointed when they get a negative feedback or report. But when we go to the Lord, he is always willing to step down to our level. And he is always willing to deal with our problems immediately. And he is always willing to show us how to live freely. I want to be free. Dikwada wikara mudu ragi yone maudu. Kugwa mudu wangai nongorodi na kwela maudu baige. But nino onyede, opuweshi ugoishi itale nyike muno. Siyate muadhani meareda, God is willing. Kuhuwa dogezi ukiura jia muadhani if you are willing. He is more than willing to deal with your problems. He is more than willing to deal or to fix your family. He is more than willing. And the moment we go to him, he will stretch his hand and deal with whatever is troubling us. He will trouble whatever is troubling us because he is a God. And don't forget the opening statement that I made, that we need to be washed in water, filled of the Holy Spirit. We need to be rubbed with salt so that we can be the salt of the earth. Then of the Sometimes we try so hard to blend in. God has called you to stand out. Netugara ya muno gutwe kata adwashi yake. No gaya twetete megana to stand out and be the salt of the earth. May the Lord God bless you and may the Lord keep you. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.